Hi, I'm Ian Small, CEO of Evernote. Today, we're behind the scenes, and we're going to do something different than we've done before. Previously, most of the episodes we've shown have focused on one individual component of the overall Evernote experience. And today, we're going to be taking a bunch of the pieces that we've already shown you, whether they've been in the web context or sometimes in the mobile context, and put them all together and give you an overview of what our new mobile experience is going to look like. And to do that, I'm here with Eric, who's going to help launch that experience out into the world and out to you. So Eric, why don't you show us where mobile is at?
Yeah, well, again, like you said, we're really excited about how we've been able to deploy a lot of these features into web, right? And now we're starting to bring them into mobile, and our users will see that on desktop as well in the near future. And so why don't we go ahead and jump into it? What I have pulled up right now is our latest mobile client. This is a preview version, and you can see here all my different notes. So the first thing I'm going to show is actually going to be our left nav. And so this is something that's actually familiar for our Android users already, but we're bringing it over to iOS. And again, it's part of that consistent experience that you're going to see across devices.
So I notice it's also very similar to what I might see on the left side of the web browser. So that's intentional. We want this to feel the same no matter what kind of device you're on.
Absolutely. So you've seen it on web. Now we're showing it to you on mobile. It'll be there on desktop. We want that to be a consistent experience for our users no matter where they're accessing their Evernote from.
Makes sense.
And so you can see here in the left nav, we have all these things like notes, shortcuts, notebooks, things that our users should be familiar with. So why don't we go ahead and jump into some of the features within our mobile clients. You've talked with May and Mariano before about how search works on web. And so a lot of our web users have had the opportunity to see how that works. Well, we're excited to show you what that looks like within the mobile client as well. So I just hit this search button here.
The first thing I notice is immediately very much the same as the web experience. I see it showing me some suggestions.
Right, exactly. You see that you have the suggested search, specific notes. And then what we're particularly excited about for mobile is now the ability to apply a filter before you actually perform a search, right? So that's something that you weren't able to do before.
All right.
Yeah. So I'm working on a shower remodel right now. And so let's say, for instance, I want to take a look at shower tiles. So I can actually filter by all the notes that I've tagged with shower tiles.
So I see the sort of pill up at the top of the screen that indicates we're filtering by a tag. In this case, it's shower tiles. These are the five notes out of all the notes that have that tag applied.
Right.
Same as on the web. If I wanted to actually get rid of that, I could just exit out immediately.
Exactly.
Can I also, like I can on the web, refine that search and narrow it further?
Exactly. So you absolutely can. For the purposes of this example, let's say I'm looking for any note that has ceramic tiles in it within this tag. So what I can do now, let's say I just want to find every note that has ceramic mentioned in it. I can actually go ahead and type it here, hit search, and you'll see that within shower tiles tagged notes, it's pulling up everything that has ceramic in it, and it's highlighting that within the note title.
So I've been able to iterate my way to the exact search that I'm looking for, the exact note I'm looking for, and get all the power that I'm used to seeing on the larger screen, I now also see on the small screen as well.
Absolutely. It's the same back-end technology. We're just bringing it to life inside of our mobile client.
It's very cool. What else we have?
Yeah, so let's say now that I'm done looking at shower stuff, and I want to take a look at what I need to do for work today. I can go ahead and actually pull up. Under shortcuts, I have work to do set up. And this will be a great opportunity to actually show you some of the cool things that our editor team has been working on. See, it'll bring me straight over into my to-do list.
So the first thing I notice when I look at the screen is this new button at the bottom that says edit.
Yep. So one of the pieces of feedback that we've heard from a lot of users is actually that they will accidentally edit notes sometimes, right? We've all done it. We've accidentally tapped into something we didn't mean to. And so by setting up this edit button, it effectively protects the note, and you can only edit it if you intentionally want to do so.
Got it. So just like sometimes we pocket dial someone by mistake, it turns out that sometimes people pocket edit.
Exactly.
And when they pocket edit, they end up losing pieces of notes or content that they didn't actually mean to.
Exactly.
So this is designed to protect them from that.
Right.
Right now, I can consume the content, I can scroll around, I can do all those things, but I'm protected from accidentally changing it.
Exactly. So then if we click into edit, this effectively opens up the note. Let's say, for instance, that I'm done with my budget approvals here, 2020 budget approvals. One of my favorite features and a highly user-requested one is checklists that our editor team has set up. So you can see here when I check it off that it actually grays out and strikes through that item. It just visually makes it a lot easier for you to now keep track of what you've actually completed in your to-dos.
That's very cool. And just like we saw on the web, one of the things Sasha showed us was when she showed us that, she also showed us new, more powerful ways to style things, et cetera. Do we have those features in mobile as well?
Yep, the exact same ones, right? And so what you can see here, let's say I want to format Q4 deadlines, like the title to this section. Right here, for instance, if I want to change the size.
I see immediately those are the semantic styles that Sasha showed us.
Right, absolutely. I can make those changes really quickly. I can tap into here and do bolding or change the text colors. But then, of course, one of my favorites, and of course as a user requested one as well, is highlighter colors. So if I want to just apply color here, I can go ahead and set that.
Got it. So now I have a properly highlighted Q4 deadlines. I've got something checked off. So this is a sort of showing us how the editor experience is starting to sort of map across the large screen device and the small screen devices, giving us consistent access to the functionality we're seeing.
Absolutely. So you're not going to experience those disruptions of, you know, being able to edit text differently in one place versus the other. And that's ultimately going to allow you to do what you need to faster.
That's really, really good.
So let's say now I'm done with work to-dos, we've jumped into a meeting, and let's say I need to quickly create a note that has a picture in it. Mm-hmm. So what we're really excited about as well that we've brought over from what our Android users have seen, and now it's new to iOS, is we have this new note button. So if I just go ahead and hit this arrow here, you can see that I can go straight into taking a photo, adding an attachment, and when I tap on this, what it'll do is automatically create a note with that content. So let's say, for instance, let's take a photo of you, and I'll use that for the note. And what you can see here is that it's created a note with the picture already present.
That there's no question that the new experience doesn't make you a better photographer.
Well, it is allowing me to create notes with pictures in them faster.
You just need better quality subject material.
So the last thing I'll show you today, something we're particularly excited about actually, is going to be tag management, right? That's something that's been an issue for our users in the past, you know, across Android and iOS. Well, we're really excited about how we've been able to improve how you're able to manage those on your mobile device.
So tags is something that have always been pretty inconsistent between iOS and Android. And Sahand and I walked through sort of on paper a lot of the designs they had for how they wanted to improve it. Are you going to show us those things brought to life?
Yeah, absolutely. Again, it'll be consistent with how you do it on desktop versus web versus the mobile client. You can see here we have this tag section. I, of course, can open this up and see all your tags right here. But what we're particularly excited about is how much tag management is now improved within the mobile client itself. So if I tap into tags here, for instance, right, you can actually nest that tag now within your mobile experience, which is new. Let's take shower tiles, for instance. Let's say I want to nest that under house. Well, I can go ahead and open up this little menu here. I'll hit move tag. And then I'll nest it under house. And you can see I have shower tiles nested.
That's a really nice thing. We've never been able to do that before on a mobile client.
Yeah, absolutely. And just in a few taps, you know, you can manage it however you need to. I can move it back out to its own tag. And now you have the freedom to manage your tags wherever you go.
That's a huge step forward. So one of the things I noticed is you've been showing us all these things in this sort of complete tour of what the mobile experience is like, but you've been showing all that to us on an iPhone.
Yeah.
Well, what if I'm an Android user?
Well, we have that same experience available on Android. So I actually have a Pixel right here. And I'll show this to you real quick. You can actually see that looks the same, works the same. We've designed them to be consistent with each other, just like we have with web and desktop.
Got it. That's fantastic. So it's basically going to be the same experience, no matter what people do, across the two devices, and a consistent experience across all their different devices.
Exactly.
All right. So where are we at in terms of putting this in front of customers?
Well, we're really excited that we've, you know, been able to bring all these features together now to a cohesive client, right? And now we're very, very close actually to releasing this to a small group of users from our beta program. And what we're ultimately doing that is giving them a preview of what's coming, and we want to hear feedback, right? We want to know how they're responding to how the redesign has gone, how the mobile client works, is it fast, are there any bugs? Because of course we want to get that feedback as soon as possible so that we can incorporate that into our development going forward.
Well, that makes sense, because while we've been able to test each individual component that we've been showing people today, we haven't actually been able to put them all together in one place in a working experience for people to actually use.
Yeah,
So this is a big step forward, and I know it's something I'm really excited about, and I'm sure our users will be excited as well.
Definitely.
So today we've done something a little different, which is instead of focusing on any one part of the Evernote experience, show you how everything we've been doing is coming together into a complete new mobile experience for Evernote users, bringing you something that's much more consistent with the experience that you have across the device set that you can use with Evernote. Thanks very much for sharing this all with us.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think it's fantastic work, and I'm looking forward to getting to the hands of users. We've been using it internally now for a while, so this is a very exciting step forward for us. So next time, I hope you'll join us behind the scenes at Evernote.